This tutorial demonstrates how to test generic units. The application we need to test is a simple calculator. It makes sense to use generic units in this case because the algorithm that performs the arithmetic operation is independent of the type of operand and the kind of operation. Note that the operands are indicated in the diagram as blue and the operations are green. The last equation shows the generic form. The algorithm in question needs to pop an operand off the stack into register one of the arithmetic logic unit, likewise for the second operand, and then the generic binary operation algorithm will perform binary operation on two operands, reg one, reg two. The result goes into register three, which is then pushed on to the stack. In the package diagram, we see that this unit here, this is the focus of this tutorial, the algorithm inside of this package. The stack is simply an abstract data type. It maintains operands on the stack, which are accessed by the various ALUs, or arithmetic logic units, shown here. We have subtraction, also shown as addition. There are two others which I'm not indicated to keep the diagram uncluttered. And the stack only depends on operands. Binary operations has visibility to both the operands on the stack and the operations. There are only two classes in this application: operands and operation. Subclasses of operand must implement the abstract method image and provide specialized methods to get and set the value internal to the object. And the three methods, as indicated as ALU result to stack, execute, and stack pair to ALU, these are the key methods associated with each arithmetic logic unit. Okay, let's take a brief look at the code. In the package operands, here we create a new abstract class to represent an operand object, and the subclass must implement the image method. In the child package ints, here we declare a type, where we create a subclass of operand called int, which is specialized to work with integers. The state of the int class is defined by a single attribute called val. Here's the implementation of the methods on the int class. In the stack specification, which contains typical methods of push, pop, length, top, next to top, won't go into detail with this package because that's not the focus of this tutorial. But it is worth mentioning that because the stack manipulates operands as class-wide objects, it is therefore important to provide a method to delete objects from the heap when they are no longer needed. That is the purpose of the instantiated procedure free. And here's the body of the stack abstract data type. In the operations package, we create the operation class and declare its abstract methods. In the child package ints, we declare the methods on the class int as the operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and modulus. And the implementation of that specification. onto the instantiated packages. When this statement is executed, the concrete package operations.addition is instantiated from the generic package operations.binary by specifying the operand type as int and the operation function as plus. The generic package then allows us to extract the same algorithm, specialized to deal with subtraction in this case, multiplication, and modulus. Now we're in the generic unit, the focus of this tutorial. All binary operations on scalar types in this application use the same algorithm. Therefore, in order to enable code reuse, this package is implemented using generic parameters. The actual parameter, that is the input type, must match the signature of the formal parameter. So for example, and if operand were passed in as being of type int or in class, that would be acceptable. And for the function, if the addition function were passed in, would also enable an instantiation. And here's the generic implementation of execute. And in the private part, we also have with pre and post conditions to guard the interface, also been applied in the private part. And the implementation of the generic unit. Again, we proceed as if we had concrete parameters, but we use generic parameters instead. And I've created a test client. And when the test client is run, we see that the application works, is able to evaluate these expressions. All right, well, that's an overview of the application. This tutorial in part two will examine how we can test this generic unit, binary operations, and enable the instantiations to also inherit or to obtain the same tests from the generic to apply it to addition, subtraction, multiplication, etc.